Thursday. JR Speech here, dog. A new week. We still got all the apps, people. Speech, people are still telling me, dog, every damn week, they can't find a damn show. Dog, where? Tell them once for all, where are we all at, bro?
Man, we everywhere, dog. We on Audio Boom, of course. We on Stitcher, Spreaker, iTunes, Google Play, iHeartRadio. There's absolutely positively no way that you... We even on Blog Talk. Come on, man. People, like, yo, just hit the website. Follow the website, and everything that you need is right there. All of our connects. There's no excuse at this point. 9 different radio platforms that you can catch us whenever you want. So there's no excuse and no reason, no rhyme, no type of logic to where you can't get the show. So people, stop cheating yourself and start treating yourself. Get tuned in to the Bossman Show, TrueSpeech Thursday. We're making it happen. And I promise you, you will not be disappointed.
And along with our Instagrams, LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter. So that's 13 right there of platforms you can find this radio program. How many shows on 13 different platforms? Not very many.
Not many. I can't think of none, personally.
So, you want to consume the Bossman Show and TrueSpeech Thursday, you can do that if you so choose to. Quit emailing holler at BossmanShow.com telling me you can't find the show. That's an excuse. Type in Bossman Show. Type in TrueSpeech Thursday. You found the show because one of them are going to pop up for you in your Google search.
Absolutely, people. So it's no excuse. Get hit, get tuned in. Go ahead and get plugged into the wild fact.
You know, Speech, we had a show planned for today, but a situation popped up today off the air with a potential guest, and potential guest had a manager who got involved, Speech. And as you know, we talked about this in the past. We don't care for managers too much because managers tend to muck up the situation, make it worse. We can just talk to the person directly and get their feel for it. A lot of times these managers talk for these people and they ain't ever hear our pitch or whatever your case may be. But it's mighty funny. This individual, you know, they just kind of got hot and they hired a manager or whatever, and that's fine. But dog, me and this individual agreed they would come on the show. Exposure for exposure. You know, you come on and I promote, you promote after you promote as well. So we agreed to that. Then come this morning, individual tells me their manager needs to talk to me. An individual tells me, the manager tells me that his, quote, client can come on the show if we PayPal them $500 by 2 p.m. Eastern time today. And he got cussed out. The client and I text back and forth. The client said it was just business, and they didn't realize that they couldn't do it without their manager's permission, which is BS. But my thing about this, I hate dealing with managers and stuff because they muck up situations. Same with sports people. The media relations department with these sports teams are hell. You know, you try to get to a guy or something. They're like, nah, he can't do it. You ain't asked a man. But you tell me you can't do it. You talking for this guy. And speaking back to the manager thing, Speech, Willie D of the Ghetto Boys, a very famous rapper from Houston. How is it that I can email and text him directly and get a response from him to come on the show without a fee, but somebody who just got hot wants $500 and they PayPal by 2 p.m. with a simple stipulation? Are you kidding me, Speech?
Bro, I understand business is business. I get that. I completely understand. But when it comes to managers, a lot of people hire individuals that aren't necessarily qualified to make managerial decisions, but they have this title of quote-unquote manager, and they assume that they know what they're doing, and they assume they know what they're talking about. I mean, everybody with a laptop and a cell phone or an iPad is not a manager. Everybody that may know somebody is not qualified to be a manager. A lot of people, they assume that once you get a manager, that makes it official or that makes you solidified in your position or whatever you're trying to do. That's not the case. A lot of people actually have stagnated themselves because they wanted to get a manager. Dude, I've been doing hip-hop for years. I don't have a manager. If somebody needs to talk to me, get at me. Talk to me. I have a business partnership with the guys, my family, and whenever we have an opportunity, we all come to the table, we talk about it, or we text, like, send information, like, hey, I wish y'all think about this, blah, 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 blah. And we make a decision as a group, as a collective. But even if I didn't have that collective, I don't need a manager. What do you need a manager for? You know what you will and you won't do. You know what's, you should know what's good and what's not. Now, for people that just getting into whatever industry they're getting into, cool, I understand that. You might need somebody to help guide you or something like that. But at the same time, you have to learn how to speak up and make decisions for yourself. You can't let another individual make all the decisions for you because you don't know what their qualifications are. You go out and get a quote-unquote manager because they call themselves a manager, could actually stagnate you. Now, I'm not degrading anybody. I ain't talking bad to anybody. If you got a manager and your manager is on it and they know how to handle business and get things done, that's cool. That's great. But please, please, please vet your management more carefully and more thoroughly. Do your due diligence on who you allow to manage you. And keep in mind, before you pay somebody 10, 15, 20, 30% of whatever you bring in, make sure they have your best interest at heart and they're not actually trying to screw you over. Because a lot of times what we've encountered with managers is a manager will come up with this arbitrary number and just so they can make sure that they get their cut. Cool. I understand that. You doing a service for somebody, get paid. But don't try to screw me over and screw my partner over and screw us over as a collective because you're trying to fatten your pockets and make yourself look more official. Like, hey, look, this is what I did for you. No, it don't work like that.
And furthermore, if you agree to sign with me without your manager, why are you why would you back out of it because of your manager? When me and this individual agreed to a situation without the manager being involved. So you let the manager kill our agreement, really?
Too many Indians. I'm sorry, too many chiefs. Everybody want to be a chief. Nobody want to be an Indian. Can't have a whole bunch of chiefs running around. Somebody gotta leave. Somebody gotta take the head. It's like, come on, man. Everybody can't be in the kitchen cooking at the same damn time. Then stuff just get all over the place. And that ain't good business.
And I don't want to brag or be braggadocious, but here's an example. If you go on the Bossman Radio Show website in the show archive, I've interviewed the Hawks CEO, Steve Koonin, for free. Hall of Famer, WWF Jim Ross, for free. I've interviewed Dummy Rogers Cromartie, for free. Mike Conley of the Grizzlies, for free. Willie D, for free. Dave Lado of DePaul, for free. Ben Howland of Mississippi State, for free. Now I'm going to list some upstart. Give me for some paper. And I've interviewed high top of the end people for nothing other than their time and exposure. Are you kidding me? How dare you and your manager try to punk TrueSpeech and myself and the Bossman Entertainment Group? We don't play that way. This is our thing. To anybody listening to the show, any potential guest listening to the show, either you want to be on or you don't, okay? We don't care which one it is. We can go on without you, as you can see. We have a guest some week. Some week don't have a guest. The show's still good without you. We don't need you for content. We can draw our own content. So when you think you're hurting us, you're not. We don't need you one way or another. We've been going strong 5 years without you. We'll go on 5 more years without you. Speech and myself have a system here and a product here that you can't touch or match. And we're on 13 platforms. Where else are you going to get to be on 13 platforms at other than this radio program and the Bossman Entertainment Group? The Bossman Show, Speech Thursday. Come on. So, Speech, once again, people are so short-sighted and miss out on their blessings for being too selfish and having that pig-like, big shot mentality.
Crazy, man. People need to realize you got to crawl before you can walk. And that's really the easiest way to put it. Everybody want to just hit the ground running, which is cool. Some people can, but everybody ain't built for that, though. People have to build a strong foundation before you get into the process of demanding. But it is what it is. It is what it is, man.
Exactly. Folks, I'm sorry to do that today, but it wasn't the show plans, but since of what's been going on behind the scenes of the show, we had to let you all know and kind of give you some insight of what's going on behind the scenes of the show, how we try to get guests for you. We email for guests every week. We reach out to people. Some people choose to come on, some people don't. That's the nature of the business, okay? It's business we in. Some people say yes, some people say no. You know, so just understand, we're working for you, and we're never going to let you be cheated or take advantage of you by somebody else. So with that being said, we're going to take a step from this, take a break from this, come back after the break, and hit up the NFL Week 4 recap, because we have a lot going in the NFL. So we'll talk about after the break. So Speech and Myself be back after the break. NFL recap next.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you 2 discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh. Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
TrueSpeech Thursday, JR and Speech here with you. We're going to talk about NFL, niggas. A hot NFL week 4. And Speech, I'm going to let you talk about your lines, man. I watched some of the game at the Georgia Dome in the press box a little bit in between, watching the Panthers and the Falcons. And going down for late in the second half, Stafford threw a pick that was just horrible, like, for real. Like, the Lions could easily won that game. They scored in the red zone, but they didn't. The same way they lost to Tennessee, or they get going too late, man. So, what's your sense of the Lions losing to the hapless Chicago Bears to Brian Hoyer without Jay Cutler out there?
I mean, it was hurtful. Like, I'm not even going to lie. As a Lions fan, bro, it was hurtful. First of all, Bears are a division rival. Everybody from the Midwest knows. Lions, Bears, Lions, Packers, Lions, like, those are the games you watched. NFC North, those are rivalry games, bro. All of them. And we blew it. Not to Jay Cutler, but to Brian Hoyer. Let's keep it a buck. all the way real. We lost to Brian Hoyer. And once again, the Lions did what the Lions always do. We beat ourselves. That pick that Stafford threw, and I'm a critic of Matthew Stafford. I am very critical of him because I'm not 100% behind him. This ability to make sound decisions. But that was Golden Tate's fault. He ran a straight go route. He was supposed to stop and come back. I'm like, dog, you missed the hitch. What are you doing? And you could tell that he messed up on the route. So the Lions are making unnecessary mental errors as always. We can't score in the red zone to save our life. God, I miss Jason Hansen. Another thing, I'm all over the place, dog, but I'm frustrated as a Lions fan. I'm very frustrated this season. What's always saved us in the past in these critical situations where we had to have fourth quarter comebacks, late third quarter comebacks, second half turnarounds, we had Jason Hansen, who was the most clutch kicker of all time, probably next to Adam Vinatieri or Sebastian Janikowski, and we had Megatron. So all we had to do was get anywhere past the hell 50-yard line, Jason Hansen automatic. Get lucky, throw it up, Megatron gonna go up and get it over anybody. We don't have those people anymore. We don't. Jason Hansen retired, Megatron retired. So now we're really seeing the Lions' skeletal system for what it is, and it's fractured. Mental errors and mental mistakes, and every week we managed to beat ourselves. That game against Tennessee was a winnable game. That game against Chicago, winnable game. We've only taken one serious whooping this season that I will honestly say we've got outplayed, and we just wasn't in the zone. All the other games that we've had this year, dog, that we've lost, winnable games. Winnable games.
I agree, and what about Ryan Fitzpatrick, man, throwing 9 picks in 2 weeks? Like, if they're Geno Smith, they'll be calling for his head. I mean, Geno probably could do better than Fitzpatrick at this point, right?
I mean, I would agree, dude. Let's keep it 100. The only reason Geno Smith doesn't have a starting job was because he got into a fight with a dumbass linebacker last year and broke his jaw. Geno Smith had the starting job last year. He was the starting quarterback. He had to miss some time. And I guess, you know, he just wasn't crisp and precise. But, I ain't never had my jaw broke, so I don't know what it feels like. So I'm assuming mentally he probably wasn't in it. But that's the only reason Ryan Fitzpatrick really had that job. Let's be all the way real. So I think they need to make a change, dude. 9 picks in 2 weeks is unacceptable. Hell, most quarterbacks don't throw 9 picks in a season, let alone in 2 weeks. And, dude, this is honestly the first quarter of the season. We'll be 4 games down, right?
Mm-hmm.
Before going into week 5. 16-game season. So that's the first quarter of the season right now. So the first 25% of the season, you throw 9 picks. I would bench him immediately, if not cuff him. Period. I don't care what his name is. Ryan Fitzpatrick, it doesn't matter. Like, at this point, even if he was an elite quarterback, you're getting benched. And you need to figure out what the hell is wrong with you so you keep throwing interceptions and making mental errors. You're not in communication with receivers. And I don't understand why he's throwing so many picks. I mean, Brandon Marshall was on fire 2 weeks ago, dog. What was the stat line? 9 for 150 with 3 touches?
Remember, he was playing the Bills, so that helped.
Well, that did help, too. But to me, that said that Brandon was – I forgot about that. That was against the Bills. But at the same time, though, that showed me that Brandon Marshall still got some in the tank. The boy's still competitive, and the man still got hands. So at the end of the day, if you can't even get the ball to your best receiver, which is Brandon Marshall, let's be honest, he will probably one day be – Brandon Marshall probably going to be in the Hall of Fame stats-wise. He might sneak in there. But we're talking about an elite-level receiver in Brandon Marshall. He is. What he wants to be and when he's healthy. If you can't get the ball to somebody like Brandon Marshall, you need to sit your ass on the bench because you got problems. And the Jets have problems right now internally.
They have 4 quarterbacks, Fitzpatrick, Bryce Petty, Geno Smith, and Christian Hackenberg. What are they doing there? That's ridiculous.
Nothing. Nothing. I'm like, dog, you got 4 quarterbacks, and you need to tell me you haven't made a rotation as you get. That game when he played last week, what did they play last week when he threw 6 picks?
Kansas City.
You throw 6 picks against the Chiefs?
Who got beat like a fool against Pittsburgh Sunday night.
Dog. Crazy, wasn't it?
Exactly. Like, what?
I'm benching you. Straight up, flat out, I am benching you. If you throw 6 picks, I'm benching you. You throw 9 in 2 weeks, I am benching you. And your job is in jeopardy. Straight up. This is the National Football League, man. Don't nobody got time for those type of mistakes.
Nah, not
like I said, you're throwing to an elite-level receiver, and you can't even make it. Come on, man.
Exactly. I think it's time for the 49ers to quit being stupid and bench Blaine Gabbert. I think Cap gives them a better chance to win than Blaine Gabbert. Because the Cowboys' defense made Gabbert look kind of manageable or marginal or moderate, but he's not that good, man. The Cowboys and Dak Prescott, I want to tell you about Dak Prescott. He's playing well, but he's not throwing the ball down the field. He's pretty much throwing under 20 yards, okay? He's doing what Alex Smith does. The one thing Romo can do is go down the field. There's a threat of going deep with Romo on the field that Dak's not giving you just yet. So, all you want people to want to go to Dak, pump your brakes a little bit, I'm just saying. But Cowboys are 3-1, play the Bengals this week in Dallas. But, dog, Cap or Gabbert, who really should be out there, man?
Cap, all day. Go with Cap. Because, one, Cap knows the offense. He knows the receivers. He knows the system. Cap's still athletic. He can still throw the ball. He's had time to get his head together and get back into the game of football. To me, it's a no-brainer. Blaine Gabbert has not been playing well, in my personal opinion. If I was making the decision, I'd go with Cap. What do you got to lose? I mean, let's keep it a buck. At this point, what do you honestly have to lose? That's it. The first quarter of the season is gone. Chalk that up. Make adjustments. Adjustment number one. Colin Kaepernick. Go in there. See what he do. He's ready. I think Cap is ready. Like, he knows the system better than Blaine Gabbert ever would. Blaine Gabbert. Whatever. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Cap knows the system, bro. He has familiarity with the offense, the play call. Off top, Cap was successful. He had a bad year. You know, but Cap still Colin Kaepernick.
Exactly.
I think it's a
no-brainer. And look, the Raiders are 3-1. The only game they lost is to the Atlanta Falcons out there in Oakland somehow. But they won all three games on the road. The Raiders are balling right now under Jack Del Rio. And cue up the Autumn Wind song that the Raiders always have to cue up.
Nah, I know, right? Dude, here's the thing, though, bro. I told people, by the way, this is a side note. I picked the Bear Card Fantasy League his rookie year. Amazing. Next year, amazing. This year, somebody snatched him up, and I was pissed because I got stuck with Matthew Stafford outside of Derek Carr. All right? Now, Crab, I'm so proud of Michael Crab. She's making this turnaround, dog. I'm going to be honest. I had questions when he left Frisco. I really did. But he's managed to turn it around and show that he is worthy of all that money that people keep paying him. I'm 100% pleased with Michael Crabtree, dog. He's really been a spark. Somebody also snatched him up. I had Crabtree the past couple years, and he's done me great in fantasy league, but somebody snatched him up this year. But Derek Carr and Michael Crabtree have that chemistry. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
They got that. They got that. And I really like what they're doing right now. I like the past couple seasons, but I'm really liking where they are right now. Because now they have a routine and rotation going. It's like instinct now with those two. You know what I mean? And I like it. I really like what they're doing. So, shout out to the Raiders, man.
You know what I'm shocked? I'm shocked about is that the Los Angeles Rams are 3-1 with providing no offense in case Keenum's at quarterback. I'm shocked about
that. I don't understand that. Dude, I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't know.
Like, they have no offense at all in winning games.
But,
you know?
I don't get it. Where's Ty Gurley been at, dog? Like, I was kind of upset that somebody snatched him up first round of fantasy, but now I'm like, I don't
people
know.
People are stacking that box with eight people, nine people in the box, daring him to run the ball. He can't get nowhere.
True. But still, I mean, he's just a dynamic runner and a playmaker. I would assume he would be able to adjust for that and still be productive with it. He has not been Ty Gurley last year. I don't know what's happening, dog.
And speaking of Todd Gurley, before we close this up, you see that play between Tennessee and Georgia, the Hail Mary from Josh Dobbs to Juwan Jennings in the end zone against Tennessee in the Tennessee-Georgia game? Did you see that by any chance that last second of the game?
And I caught the highlight. Crazy, wasn't it?
Yes. Yes, indeed. Dog, I caught that game from my favorite place.
Georgia's dog.
No, Taco Mac. It was a fight after it happened.
Oh, Taco. Shout out to Taco Mac, man. Taco Mac, we love y'all, man. Y'all need to come on board, dude. We love to have Taco Mac on board with us. You know what I mean?
As much as I eat there and go there every weekend, that should be a sponsor.
I'm saying, dude, when I touch down in the A, Got a taco mac, dog. Got to do it.
Hopefully
got
you'll see a fight or a brawl or something while you're in there.
Maybe. But I will say this, though, dog. On the side, though, man, did you see all the concussions from this week, dude? What is up with the level of concussions in the NFL right now? Cam is out with a concussion.
Carson Palmer
is out with a concussion.
Larry Daniel out with a concussion. Hey, man, you got guys that be strong and fast running all as fast as they could. Heads are colliding. That's honestly what's going on.
True. But my whole thing is, I'm just trying to figure out, is it me or is it like Cam Newton isn't getting all of the special treatment and attention that other quarterbacks in the league are?
Oh, it is. It's definitely the case. You know, he's too big and he's not the gifted golden child of the quarterback position. Yes.
Yeah, man, because I've been watching, and Cam's been getting, like, knocked around.
He the hell be out of his ass.
Per se.
The hell
right.
be out of
it. Basically, he's getting beat, and he's getting abused. And as I look around, I'm like, if you so much as touch a quarterback, now, they roughing the passer, unsportsmanlike like kinda. I'm like, come on, all these penalty flags flying around. And, yeah, when I see, you know, Cam do his thing. The ref almost fired.
He getting his ass beat, dog. For real.
He is getting his ass whooped. I ain't trying to pull a particular car here, but one of these things is not like the other. It is what it is.
Exactly.
I mean, last year we all know how they try to crucify the man. So this year I find it just a little odd that he's getting absolutely positively differential treatment, and not in a good way, the other quote-unquote premier elite franchise quarterbacks around the league. I don't really think it's fair because, like you said, he's getting his ass whooped out there, dog. And I don't think Cam is going to make it through the season. I hate to say that, but being realistic, I don't think his body is going to hold up the rest of this 16-game season, bro. I don't see it because they're not protecting like they're protecting everybody else. I think it's bull, personally. You know what I mean? But it is what it is. We'll see how it play out, but Mark down the date. What is it, October 3rd? Mark down the date, October 3rd. I said it. I do not believe Cam Newton will be injury-free for the 16-game regular season. I unfortunately do not believe it. I hope this is not the case because I'm a fan of the man. But the way they're treating him right now, I don't know.
Folks, NFL Week 4 recap. Coming up next after the break is the emails. Stay tuned.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com, or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24, or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh, bringing you 2 discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
TrueSpeech Thursday, Speech and JR here with you. Dog, it's time for emails. Let's recap the NFL week 4. Time for emails now, dog. What is your feeling this week's emails? Do you feel like they'll be better than last week's, bro?
They got to be better than last week, man. I mean, last week was pretty solid. You know what I mean? Interesting. But it was a couple solid ones in there. So I think this week should be a little bit more interesting and hopefully more well-composed emails is what I'm looking forward to.
Well, here we go. Starting off with listener email. Talking show. I went to the dogger today, and he told, T-O-E-D me, that I need, N-K-E-N-E-E, to integrate, E-N-T-R-G-A-T, poultry into my diet. Now, keyword, pole, P-O-L-E, tree, into my diet. I was confused. Because I know, us human people, ants suck toes. Damn. To eat, quote, poultry, P-O-L, tree. Why would, W-O-D, I want to eat the pole that hold electricity up? Help me out, Terry in Lake County, Speech.
That was one of the most incoherent emails I think I've ever heard. Like, Jesus, what was he trying to say? All I could gather is I went to the dogger. I'm assuming he was trying to say doctor.
Yeah.
Other than that, what the hell is this fool talking about?
Dog, he's calling poultry. Like, poultry?
Dude, he said, I need to integrate more poultry. I guess he said he needed to eat more chicken? Like, dog, what the hell was he talking about?
Exactly.
That's almost as worse as that meme where somebody said bone apple tea. I'm like, you dumbass.
Exactly. Terry, please be better, Terry. I mean, get some chicken, not eating the pole to hold up the electricity, my man. That's what? Oh, we. Wow. Wow. Terrible.
Dude, I know. It's unreal. Unreal, bro. But the next one, though. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Rashad.
Who's that?
Who the hell is Rashad? Just a thought. What kind of milk do my baby be sipping for my wife, Titty? Oh, Lord have mercy. Is it D? Sweet AD, cover to skin, or some other type. My man, drop knowledge. Jalen, working at the Gap. Why are you saying it, dog? Why you put that in there, Jalen? Lord have mercy, Jalen. Dog, first of all, milk that comes from a... I'm not even... I mean, I'm at a disbelief. He's asking what type of milk comes out of a female breast. It's not the same as cow's milk, man. It's not.
It's
oh my head hurts from trying to explain this.
Exactly.
You can't put it in cereal, dog. You can't put it in a milkshake. You can't put it in your tea. you're supposed to be for the baby to drink. It ain't the same type of milk, man. It's human
not.
Milk meant for the baby. You don't leave it alone. Leave it alone, Jalen. Leave it alone. Stop taking food from the baby.
Oh, my
Rashad.
God.
Who the hell is Rashad?
Exactly. Boy, Jalen, get some help, man. Quit being jealous of your baby on your wife's titty, okay? You'll get them back soon, okay?
Let the baby eat, man.
And what the hell is cover two or skin? Cover two milk? What? Never heard of that cow milk, bro. Never heard of cover two.
I'm assuming you're trying to say either 2% or skim? Like, cover defense ain't the type of milk. This cover two, like you trying to call a play.
Exactly.
Skim milk. Cover two. What's the cover?
What?
Skim milk. Cover two. No, that's not the same.
And you said, Jalen, if you've been to the store and say it's all cover two milk, what's wrong with you, man?
Cover two. I guess Jalen must have been a football player back in the day.
Goodness gracious. Listener email. I got this two buttholes. Really?
Wow. That's not a good way to start an email.
I'm sick of you taking money out on everything. What about me, punks? If I don't want to do something, I don't have to. I'm the woman. He needs to bend to me. He said he loved me. He needs to make sacrifices, not me. F you two losers and him. I hate you all. Melanie Nakia, 2 hours away.
Well, thank you, Melanie. I appreciate that thoughtful email, sweetie. That was really, really genuine. Thank you.
We hate you, too.
And she started off so great. So nice. She started off two buttholes. That's great. That's a great way to start an email. That's how you get my attention, Melanie. But Melanie, since we're going to take it there, this attitude that you sent us in the email is exactly why Monty is not with you right now. Judging by this email, I already got you paid. I already had you paid from what my man has told us, and this email confirms it. For you to specifically say it's all about you, he has to bend to you, you do realize that relationships are a two-way street here, sweetie. So if you're not willing to compromise to him and his needs, and you think that a relationship is all about a man spoiling you, you a damn fool, and no wonder you single. And I'm not trying to be mean. I'm being 100% real, raw, and honest with you. If you have that type of mentality in a relationship, baby, then it ain't no wonder why Monty don't want to be with you. Then it wasn't going to work for the job.
I'm shocked he wanted it in the first place, reading this email. I'm shocked he wanted it in the first place, bro. This email, I would not deal with somebody with that attitude. He's a good one.
I don't know.
He tried, but ain't no way. No way. Melanie Nakia, go to hell. How about that?
This is absolutely crazy, dude. I mean, I don't, like, how do you send an email like that, bro? Like, this is, what? Come on, like, just read the email. He said he loved me. He needed to make sacrifices, not me. If you think a relationship is about a one-way sacrifice street, sweetie, you're going to be single for a long, long time. So, Melanie Nakia, now that we done called it 100,000, right? Let me just kick it real with you right now, okay? You need to get out of that mentality. Otherwise, you're going to be single for a while, for a long while. A relationship is compromised, sacrificing. That's what it's built on. If you're not willing to sacrifice as much as you want another man, or you want a man to sacrifice, or another man, because you ain't going to get money back. So your next relationship situation, if you're not willing to sacrifice and make some type of compromise, I really hope you're a cat lady. Or you might be a dog woman. But you're going to need a pet to help cope you with that loneliness, sweetie, because you got some stuff working in your head that is not conducive to a healthy relationship. So Melanie Nakia, we appreciate your email. We really do.
Go to
and I'm
hell.
I'm sorry that you feel that way. But hey, it is what it is.
I hate you too, Heifer.
That's nuts. All right. The next one. I'll take this one. Snowson and Meech. All right. When shopping for male garment coverings, where do digest? One, AC Penny. Penny spelled with an I. Billards. Kohl's. May. Space. C. Apostrophe S. Sears, spelled S-E-E space E-E-E-R-S.
Oh, God.
Marshmallows. I don't know what that is. TJ Maxx. H.H. Gregg. Cubics.
Oh, God.
Somewhere L-C-A. Spelled S-U-M-W-E-A-R-E-L-L-S-E-A-Y. Let me know, Randall, Texas.
You saw he spelled Texas wrong.
He did. T-E-X-A-S-S.
And what's that outside of it? Like, city? What does that even mean?
You know, I'm trying to figure out how in the world of technology did this brother managed to misspell every single last store on his list.
Exactly.
As all, like, all of them have the sign.
Exactly.
I mean, like if you've ever been to these stores, the signs are like a book.
Exactly. Like, what?
Yeah.
AC Penny, really? What? What does he even want? What does he even want?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Garments, coverings. I got no clue.
You mean, like, what is it? What? Hoo-wee. That's terrible.
I ain't got a clue, bro. I ain't got a clue.
Randall, please be better. I'm serious.
Please.
How you misspell every store?
I ain't got a clue.
Oh, my God. Okay, we can't do that with Randall. Dog, what is your take on today's emails, man?
I'm absolutely just, I don't know. Melanie the Kid threw me off for real. Like, that's nutty. I mean, she really went through a lot to tell us how she feels. We appreciate that. But I hope she takes what I've said and what you said and take that into consideration. You know what I mean? Like,
exactly.
That is nuts. Also, Randall, Google. Like, all these stores, you can just Google, bro. Or you can go to the stores and see how they spell. Like, come on. Come on.
And Terry, poultry. Not the...
Exactly.
What you hold the electricity on, my man. I don't want you to go out trying to eat a electric tree. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like a light stand. Like, don't do that, brother. Like, for real? Boy. Whew, folks. Hell of a show. Catch us next week. Same bad time, same bad channel. Boston Speech here. Bossman Radio Network, BossmanRadioShow.com. We are out.